out. I finally managed to get a chance to start off sewing this buddy dress that we, you know what, I've got so, I had so many interruptions these days that I've just not been able to get around to make a start. Now the dress itself is very simple to make. First thing we do is attach the shoulders, do the shoulder seam, because then we're going to attach the neckline. So just a straight seam going all the way across the shoulder, just go all the way through to the all the way on the back of the dress, going on to the second shoulder seam, and just stitch all the way across. Now once you've done that, just trim away your threads and measure the whole of the neckline, which is just back out a little bit so you can see what I'm doing. Now that's the whole of the neckline. I've just gripped it in to the neckline. It's approximately 12 inches, so in total it's 24. Now the piece that I'm going to attach for the neck is one that I have cut previously. This is the one that I've cut, so I need this 24 inches. This is actually 25 inches, so if we take the 1 inch for, you've got to make sure that the stretch is this way. And if you stitch half an inch in on either side, it will give you a 24 inch left. Now there's a couple of things that you can do once you've stitched this, and that is that you can open this up and iron it flat like this, so that it stays, the seam stays open. Or what you can do is you can actually stitch over this like this just to keep the seam open, or you can leave it as it is. It's all freehand. Now what we're going to do is we're going to attach the neckline. If we center both of these, just to make sure that we've got a guideline. So on the back, just hold the two seams together, and on the back notch that so you know where the center of the back seam is. Also center the front so that you know where the center of the front seam is. Okay, that's our dress centered. Secondly, you need to center, we know for the back where the seams are, that's the back of our dress. For the front of the dress, we're going to notch it right in the center. So here we're going to open up the both the seams, and we're going to attach. Now we're going to do the seams on the outer side and on the inner side. I'm going to show you how. I mean, I did this the other day, and then I ended up attaching it by hand because it was a little bit velvet was a little bit stretchy, so it didn't really work out too well when I stitched it all along. Now I'm going to stitch this. I've got the neck neck underneath, and my chemise on the top. I've started stitching this from the center outwards towards the front. And the only thing that I've got to do is make sure that the center notch matches the center of my neckline over here. Now there is a slight bit, I could have done with it slightly less. Don't sew too far in, sew approximately half one centimeter in. Okay, and you'll see your notches, your two notches should actually match here. Now there is another version of the cowl neck I'm going to teach you, but that I'm going to do on a chiffon based fabric. That is one of my true spectacular necklines. I absolutely love that neckline. It's the waterfall type of the cowl neck, and it is truly amazing, that neckline is. You know what, when I was younger and in my younger days, I actually saw a neckline in that, and it was a truly amazing neckline. I've never seen a neckline in the waterfall cowl neckline ever done like that. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to replicate that. I don't know who made it. I've tried several times, and it is my lifelong ambition to actually one day to truly, I can't explain how the folds around the neck fell on that. It was absolutely stunning, and it was, you know, generally I can replicate a lot of stuff, but this was one neckline that I was not, and I mean I was not able to replicate that. And, I feel truly disappointed that I wasn't able to copy that, but then it just teaches you that you know what, we're not perfect, and there are things that we simply cannot do. Right, so that is, I mean, this one is very easy to do. It's all we need to do is attach this on the inside, and then the folds of this just sort of fall like that. So all it is just a round, sort of a round ball type of attachment, which is dead simple. It's no there's nothing to it, absolutely nothing to it. There is a bit of a stupid mistake that I've just gone and done, and you can tell with the color variation on this. I should actually have, I could kick myself for this. I should have felt for the velvet, and I should have actually done this so that you know what, the velour felt downwards, which I didn't, but you know what, never mind, it's a learning thing. I'm not really too bothered about the effect. It should have fallen, you know, down like this, so that it, you know, you can actually slightly tell the color variations on this. Now there's two things that I explained earlier, there's two things that we can do. We can either do an attachment that's sort of like on the inside, but because the velvet is slightly bit stretchy, I had a problem with this the other day when I did this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the easy option out. If it was some other material, I would have showed you how to do that. Generally what happens with that is it's sort of stitched like this all the way around. If you remember, I showed you on in one of the lessons earlier on, I did this on a hem of a dress. So it's a similar type of a technique, but because the velvet is stretchy, and I ended up getting a twist in it the other day, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this, and I'm going to actually do the tarpai on this. So I'm going to do the turning on the inside of the neck just like this, and do the tarpai on the edges all the way around the neckline, whereby attaching it. The other things that we need to do now is I'm going to take a little pause and attach the sleeves on.